Oh my! Are you kidding me? Jesus Christ! It's the Dominator! It's Bobby Lashley! Making his return to Monday Night Raw, he's rushing the ring! He's rushing the ring and he takes down the Monster Among Men! The Dominator, Bobby Lashley! We cannot believe this, I cannot believe what I'm seeing! Bobby Lashley is manhandling Braun Strowman! It's been over 10 years since we've seen Bobby Lashley on Monday Night Raw, and here he is, swinging a steel chair like a maniac to the Monster Among Men. I cannot believe this. Bobby Lashley wielding a steel chair, taking it to Braun Strowman. We never thought something like this would happen. And look at this, Lashley now sending Strowman face first into the corner. An unbelievable moment here tonight on Monday Night Raw. If you ever doubted the power of this man, you should know Bobby Lashley is a force to be reckoned with, a former WWE United States Champion, former ECW Champion, a master of mixed martial arts. And look at the way he manhandles Braun Strowman. When's the last time you saw someone manhandle Braun Strowman in the way Bobby Lashley is doing it right here tonight on Raw? The WWE Universe here tonight in Baltimore, they are in shock. Bobby Lashley just completely decimating Braun Strowman here tonight. And look at this, look at how Lashley just lifts Braun Strowman with ease. Check this out. He calls that the Dominator, the Running Power Slam. My goodness, take a look at this one more time. I never seen someone leave Braun Strowman with such ease. Take notice, everybody. Bobby Lashley has arrived to Monday Night Raw. He just took out the Monster Among Men. An incredible way to kick off Monday Night Raw. And we're keeping the ball rolling, ladies and gentlemen, because up next, the Cruiserweight title on the line. Buddy Murphy, Cedric Alexander, Raw rolls on. The best kept secret has arrived on Monday Night Raw. Here comes Buddy Murphy. Buddy Murphy came all the way from NXT as part of the Cruiserweight Championship Tournament that took place on the WWE Network earlier this year. And now as part of the Monday Night Raw brand in the Cruiserweight division, Buddy Murphy has one goal in mind, and that is to become Cruiserweight Champion. Buddy Murphy has been going back and forth with Cedric Alexander on social media, warning him that tonight here in Baltimore, the age of Alexander is going to end. Question is, does the juggernaut have what it takes to topple a man who had to claw his way through a crowded field to become Cruiserweight Champion? And here comes Cedric Alexander, the Cruiserweight Champion. You know, this is the first time the Cruiserweight Championship has been defended on Monday Night Raw for quite some time.
and Cedric Alexander wants to make this title defense worth it. He wants to give the WWE Universe their money's worth while at the same time trying to topple the juggernaut known as Buddy Murphy. But this is what Cedric Alexander knows. He knows how to overcome obstacles. He knows how to get over barriers. That's exactly how he got to the position he is today. That's exactly how he became Cruiserweight Champion. Tonight, he gets to show us what he's made of. And there you see it on your TV screens, ladies and gentlemen. Cruiserweight Championship on the line. We'll send it down to ringside for official introductions. Cruiserweight Championship up for grabs. The first time this championship will be defended on Monday Night Raw in 2018. Cedric Alexander won that championship back at WrestleMania, defeating Mustafa Ali. And Buddy Murphy became number one contender to the championship soon after. The referee makes this one official as we are set for this title matchup. There's the bell, here we go, Cruiserweight Championship on the line. They lock up. These two have to be separated. Called on an elbow again. Buddy Murphy wins that one. Applying pressure to the arm of Alexander. Alexander twists and turns, he turns this one to his favor. Alexander takes down the number one contender to Gambis. Caught on elbow again between Alexander and Murphy. The two meet on the ropes. The referee once again has to separate them. Nice reversal here by Alexander. Alexander hooks him in now. Takes him down to the canvas. Job well done by the Cruiserweight Champion. Looks to follow up from the second rope, waiting for Murphy to be in position off the second rope, dropping the elbow, beautifully done by the Cruiserweight Champion. Shoulders down, first cover of the match, hooks the leg for the championship and a kick out by Murphy. And there is a reason why Buddy Murphy has been going with the name of Juggernaut. And it's because since he arrived in the Cruiserweight division, he wants to do nothing but to roll everybody, destroy everything, defeat the status quo and become champion. He runs into someone like the heart of the Cruiserweight division, which is what we call Cedric Alexander, and he's in trouble. Alexander now with this submission maneuver, subduing his opponent Buddy Murphy here. But Murphy finds a quick way out of that submission maneuver. Murphy now hooks him in, belly-to-belly suplex to the champion. Murphy knows Lauch is a former NXT Tag Team Champion, but he says his time waiting is done. He wants his spotlight here in the main roster, here on Monday Night Raw, as the Cruiserweight Champion of the Cruiserweight Division. Of course, that belongs to Monday Nights. Alexander now, up the third row, beautifully done, shoulders down, hooks both legs, championship on the line, and a kick out by Buddy Murphy. If you're the Cruiserweight Champion, you strategize. How do you keep Buddy Murphy down? How do you subdue him like he's doing right now, which is what brings Cedric Alexander to trial of the submission maneuvers. He tries to keep Buddy Murphy grounded. Buddy Murphy, a very agile, very fast man, very good striker, as you saw from the way that he got out of that submission maneuver. Cedric Alexander is basically on a whole new game plan here. Usually game plan for the Cruiserweight division is high-flying action. Pebble to the metal, if you will, but Buddy Murphy, very good technician. Very good at keeping this match on the mat. And Cedric Alexander has to adjust to that. Alexander now hooks him in. European uppercut. Alexander with the driver. Sends him down. Shoulders down. Hooks both legs for the title. A kick out by Buddy Murphy. And you can tell that Cedric Alexander is giving it his all, using a lot of energy here against Buddy Murphy. You don't want to show your opponent that you're getting tired too quickly into the match. Murphy now hooks him in. Ooh, drops him down. Gutbuster. And Buddy Murphy takes control. Oh, spoke too soon there. Reversal by Alexander. Alexander hooks him in. Whacks him down in the canvas. Vintage Alexander. Shoulders down. Hooks the leg and the ropes allow Buddy Murphy to continue in this match. Cedric Alexander is going to try to capitalize on this. He gets him away from the ropes. Shoulders down again. Hooks the leg and a kick out by Buddy Murphy. And here comes Alexander. He's headed to the top rope. Alexander is headed to the top rope, but Buddy Murphy, very smart. Oh, yes, Buddy Murphy, very smart. Not only did he stood up, but he blocked Alexander's missile dropkick. Now Murphy hooks him in. Free DDT. Beautifully done, DDT, shoulders down. Good win of the championship here. Cruiserweight title on the line and a kick out by the champion. If you're Buddy Murphy, you're looking for the kill. You're looking for the double shot. He tries to hook him in, but Alexander with the reversal. Very well done by the champion. We talked about this. Alexander is the heart of the Cruiserweight division. He's not going to go down that easy. Alexander hooks him in again. Drives him down in the canvas for the second time in this match. Shoulders down. Is it enough to put him away here for the Cruiserweight championship? Is it enough? And a kick out at two. By Buddy Murphy. What a near fall by the number one contender. That could have been it right there for Buddy Murphy. His dreams of becoming Cruiserweight champion were gonna go up in smoke up until a second ago. And now in the ropes, Buddy Murphy has given an idea perhaps to the Cruiserweight champion Cedric Alexander, tossing Buddy Murphy to the outside of the ring. Alexander with some bad intentions here. Things are not looking well for the number one contender. Topper Suicida! And the crowd here tonight in Baltimore, they say this is awesome, and I agree. Things are getting too spicy for the pepper here tonight on Monday Night Raw. Alexander using the ropes to his advantage. I should say the barricade to his advantage. The ref is counting. Remember, Alexander has champion's advantage, but that's not the way Alexander wants to retain his championship. Alexander returning to the ring, perhaps giving too much time to Murphy. And this is exactly what we're talking about. Wow! Kick to the back of the head out of nowhere by Buddy Murphy. Follows it up with a cover with the Cruiserweight title on the line. And a kick on it too. Another near fall. Incredible action here tonight by the Cruiserweights on Monday Night Raw. And now, Murphy to the ropes. Reversal. Alexander takes him down with the head scissors. And that's exactly one of the reasons why Alexander is Cruiserweight champion. Alexander is headed to the top rope. Buddy Murphy's on the other side of the ring. Alexander, top rope. He lands it. He lands the frog splash. Shoulders down. Hooks the leg. Title on the line and a kick out of two by Buddy Murphy. The incredible athleticism of our Cruiserweight individuals here tonight on Monday Night Raw. Let me tell you, the crowd here tonight in Baltimore, everybody on their feet for the Cruiserweight champion Cedric Alexander and Buddy Murphy. Alexander now tries to hook him in. Reversal by Murphy with a clothesline. And now Murphy takes control of this matchup. Murphy now hooks him in for another DDT. That could be the seal. We could have a new champion. Shoulders down to crown a new champion. Cruiserweight title on the line. A kick out by the champ. Back and forth we go. And Buddy Murphy may be getting a little bit too comfortable here. You don't want to get too loud. This is exactly what we're talking about. Look at this. Murphy with a reversal. He blocks Cedric Alexander. And he hooks him in. Belly to belly suplex. Buddy Murphy could be well on his way to becoming the new Cruiserweight Champion. Murphy hooks him in. Murphy's Law, that's it. We're going to crown a new champion, that's it. Buddy Murphy pulls him away from the ropes to make sure he doesn't reach for them. Shoulders down, Cruiserweight Championship on the line, and a kick out at two. This is so good, ladies and gentlemen. This is Monday Night Raw. We are live tonight in Baltimore, Maryland. The Cruiserweight Championship, it's on the line. As Cedric Alexander takes on Buddy Murphy. And these two are still in the show in the first match of the night. Alexander takes him down. Shoulders down here. Cruiserweight Championship on the line and a kick out by Murphy. Cedric Alexander maybe planning a comeback after surviving the Murphy's Law move. Here comes Alexander. Alexander setting it up here. And take a look at this clothesline by Alexander. We are back down here as Alexander plants him. Alexander is looking to retain his championship. Lumbar check. The lumbar check by Alexander to retain the gold. Shoulders down. Hooks the leg. Got him. What a match. Take a look at this one more time. The clothesline by Alexander. Murphy's Law by Buddy Murphy. We don't know how Alexander survived that. And then the lumbar check. Cedric Alexander is still champion. And a show of respect by Buddy Murphy. These two competitors know they just had an excellent match, and well, our main event, they have to follow that, ladies and gentlemen. Finn Balor goes one-on-one with Kevin Owens tonight. And of course, our big main event, the Intercontinental Champion Seth Rollins goes one-on-one against Roman Reigns. It's the man of the Fatal 4-Way at Backlash in singles action in our main event, Raw tonight. And we are back live on Monday Night Raw! This is Universe Mode on Twitch! And ladies and gentlemen, it will be 3 weeks Universe time when Kevin Owens steps in the ring to try and capture his second world championship here in the WWE. Kevin Owens is a former Universal Champion. As we know, that championship has disappeared on the face of the earth. We haven't seen Brock Lesnar in over a month. We have to assume that Brock Lesnar no longer cares about being Universal Champion. At least that's what Kurt Angle assumed when he pitted Kevin Owens, Finn Balor, Roman Reigns, and Seth Rollins to compete in a fatal four-way match to crown a new WWE World Heavyweight Champion at Backlash in 3 weeks Universe time. Of course, Kevin Owens would love to once again be World Champion here on Monday Night Raw, but first, he has to get through this man and the Intercontinental Champion, and of course, the Big Dog as well. Balor Club is for everyone here in Baltimore, Maryland tonight. As Finn Balor makes his way out. The Demon King, Finn Balor, is bringing his club here to Baltimore tonight to try and rack up momentum for what could be the biggest world championship match in Monday Night Raw history. In 3 weeks universe time, when we head to Newark for WWE's Backlash. Finn Balor was the first ever Universal Champion, and after he surrendered that championship due to injury, he never got a shot to get that championship back. Finn has said that the opportunity for redemption is there, waiting, and he's going to take it in 3 weeks universe time at Backlash when he fights Owens, Rollins, and Reigns for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship. Some could say that Finn Balor has had a rocky return to WWE after his injury, failing to win the Royal Rumble and failing to capture the Intercontinental Championship at WrestleMania, but this could be the opportunity Balor needs to get back on top. Kevin Owens, Finn Balor set for action here tonight. There's the bell, here we go. Call down elbow tie up. Owens going behind Balor. These two certainly do know each other very well. It was back in 2015 at WWE's Beast in the East, our special live event from Japan, when Kevin Owens defeated, when Finn Balor defeated Kevin Owens for the NXT Championship. Owens had just made his main roster debut here, defeating John Cena at Elimination Chamber, but eventually lost his NXT Championship against Balor. The two would fight for it at NXT TakeOver Brooklyn, the first edition, in a ladder match for the championship. So these two certainly know how to keep track of each other from their NXT days. You see it in that reversal right there, telegraph move by Finn Balor. Balor with a DDT over Owens. Balor hooks him in, going for a DDT, but look at that, Owens! Owens with the reversal. Well taught out by Owens here. Slams Balor back down to the canvas, shoulders down, hooks the leg and a kick out by Balor. And it's all about building momentum towards the World Championship match at Backlash in 3 weeks universe time. When, of course, in the ring, Balor and Owens will be joined by Seth Rollins and Roman Reigns. Oh, there it is again. Fighting for the World Championship, Rollins and Reigns will be in our main event tonight, one-on-one as well. Nice reversal there by Finn Balor. Finn Balor tries to follow it up here. Carries Kevin Owens in for the Godbuster. Beautifully done there. Balor trying to capitalize up the Godbuster. He hooks Kevin Owens in. Powerbomb on Owens! And Balor is showing perhaps an aggressive side we hadn't seen before. Here's Balor off the top rope, waiting on Owens to get back to his feet. Finn Balor off the top rope. He has Owens in right position. Owens got him! Owens got him! Powerbomb! Owens got Balor off the top rope, sends him down for the powerbomb. But Balor fights off Kevin Owens here. Slim Blade by Balor. And all of a sudden, the Demon King is in control here tonight. Both of these men got a taste of what the Universal Championship used to be. And neither of these men actually got rematches for their titles after losing them. So it means the world to both of these men to be part of the World Championship matches that take place at Backlash in 3 weeks universe time. but it would mean more if they could walk out of North with that new World Heavyweight Championship around their waist. Owens now sending Balor into the corner. Shoulder first into the corner. Or into the post, I should say. Kevin Owens taking some distance. Cannonball by Owens. And Owens now takes down Balor, shoulders down. Is it enough to put Balor away here in a kick out by the Demon King? Look at that. Balor moving out of the way. And the reversal by Balor. Codebreaker! Chris Jericho would be proud of that huge codebreaker performed by Finn Balor. And Finn now clotheslines Kevin Owens. Kevin is on the outside of the ring as the ref starts to count. Very confident Finn Balor here tonight. Of course, Balor owns two victories over Kevin Owens back on NXT. This is the first time they face off one-on-one on Monday Night Raw. Balor returns to the ring before Kevin Owens can get back at him and match back in between the ropes, but not for long. Over the third rope goes Balor, into the outside sends him Owens. Owens now hits the top rope. Balor is on the outside. Bad intentions. Frog splash! A huge frog splash off the top rope to the outside of the ring. Takes out all the air of a Finn Balor. And it seems like Kevin Owens might be going for a countout victory here. Hold on a second. The ref is down. The ref is down. And Owens is looking for a weapon under the ring. He's going to take a swing at Balor, and Balor stops him. Balor stops Owens from taking a swing. And Finn Balor trying to keep that weapon away from Owens at all costs. And Owens and Balor now fighting for the weapon, but the ref is back on his feet. DDT by Owens. He has to continue this match without the advantage as the referee now takes care of the weapon. Reversal by Balor. Reversal by Owens, back and forth we go. Owens sends Balor once again outside the ring. And Owens may be going for a countout victory here, perhaps a breather to recompose himself. In this one-on-one matchup, Kevin now taunting Finn Balor from inside the ring. The count is up to five, and Balor returns to the ring. Balor now sending Owens into the corner. Owens in a bad position here as Balor continues the attack. But Owens, very smart, rolls out to the outside of the ring. The fight continues on the outside of the ring. Crucifix takedown by Balor. That could not feel good in the shoulders of Kevin Owens, hitting the hard ground of the Royal Farms Arena tonight here in Baltimore, Maryland. But once again, Kevin Owens with the advantage, looking for a countout victory. In 3 weeks Universe time, when these two join Roman Reigns and Seth Rollins in the World Championship match at Backlash, there will be no countouts and no disqualifications. So Owens could be free to use that weapon that he wanted to use earlier tonight. Here's the cover, shoulders down. Is it enough to Balor away and kick up a batter? Owens would be used to use that weapon. He would be free to use that weapon. But also, he wouldn't be able to count on a countout victory like he is right now. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no, 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 no. DDT! A huge DDT by Owens, and it seems like Owens is once again putting his eggs on the countout basket. And if you think about it, this is a very smart strategy by Kevin Owens. You win this match by countout, you don't force yourself too much, you don't injure yourself perhaps heading into Backlash in 3 weeks Universe time. You have to keep yourself top shape heading into Backlash, and that is exactly what Kevin Owens is doing. Reversal by Balor, back and forth we go. Balor now trying to regain control of this match, but Owens is not allowing it. Reversal by Balor, back and forth we go. Balor takes him down to the canvas. Beautifully done. Balor should go for the cover after that, but Kevin Owens doesn't allow it. Nope. These two know each other so well, to the point where they can counter each other attacks in a way we've never seen before. And Owens now sending Balor to the outside of the ring. Things are not looking great for the Irishman. Kevin Owens following Balor to ringside. And now Owens hooks him in. Oh, no, 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 no. Pop up powerbomb on the apron. Pop up powerbomb on the apron. And once again, Owens is putting his eggs in the countout basket. Count of four here. Finn Balor in a precarious position, and Owens hits to the outside of the ring now. Sending Balor against the barricade. Hooks him in here. Takes him down on the ground. So far, it's been all Owens in this match, ladies and gentlemen. And as the match continues now on the outside of the ring, we're going to take a look one more time at that pop-up powerbomb on the outside of the ring. Take a look at this one more time. Just boom! Balor's back, hitting the apron. That is the hardest part of the ring, ladies and gentlemen. Count of six here. And it seems like Kevin Owens is getting that count-out victory after all. Oh man, what a senton by Kevin Owens. All the way for the super kick, but Balor blocks it. Balor blocks the super kick. And a reversal by Owens. And suddenly the match returns to the ring before that 10 count. And Owens slams Balor down. Shoulders down, hooks the leg, he's hitting off to put Balor away here. Oh, and a kick out at two. A very close near fall. You can see the expression of Kevin Owens thinking this match won't end. To the outside once again, and Kevin Owens, some bad intentions here as he sends Balor into the barricade. And Finn Balor being put in a precarious position here. Whoa, what a spear! A huge spear through the barricade! I cannot believe my eyes! The amount of punishment Finn Balor has taken here tonight is quite incredible. And this one should end right here. Count of six. Count of seven. Come on, Finn. Come on, hello. Come on, Owens. Goes to the outside of the ring. Tries to look for another weapon. He tries to clothesline Balor. Balor moves out of the way. Finn Balor now over Owens. Owens sends Balor into the barricade. Balor once again into the barricade. Owens. Oh, reversal by Balor. Neck breaker on the outside of the ring. The ref is counting. Count of five on both of these men. Reversal by Owens. Sending Balor into the steel steps. Count of six here. Count of seven. Things are... Oh, wait for the super kick again, but Balor moves out of the way. Balor blocking that super kick. And Balor sends Owens into the ring. And Owens may be in the drop zone. But Owens rolls out of the ring. Owens rolls out of the ring, avoiding the coup de grace. Balor. No, no! Owens ruins this incredible match with a steel chair over and over again on Balor. And we are back live on Monday Night Raw. This is Universe Mode on Twitch. Nia Jax making her way out of here, and she looks very confident. She looks more than ready for her championship defense in 3 weeks Universe time when she puts her Raw Women's title up for grabs against Alexa Bliss at Backlash. Of course, this is Alexa's mandatory rematch after Nia Jax took the Raw Women's Championship from her at WrestleMania. Alexa Bliss has not had fine words to say about Nia Jax heading into this championship match in 3 weeks Universe time at WWE's Backlash event. Nonetheless, Nia Jax looks more than ready for Backlash. Matter of fact, tonight Nia Jax has a bit of a hurdle to climb as she takes on the former WWE Women's Champion Mickie James. And you gotta be wondering if what we're seeing here tonight is Alexa Bliss sending someone to do her dirty work for her. As Mickie James is well known, best friends with Alexa Bliss. And we can't help but to think that perhaps Alexa sent her out here for this match against Nia Jax to try and soften up the Raw Women's Champion 3 weeks before their title match at Backlash. The question is, does Mickie have what it takes to actually overcome Nia Jax and actually accomplish the task at hand, which would be to suffer her up ahead of the title matchup in 3 weeks Universe time at WWE's Backlash event? There's the bell, here we go. Nia Jax goes one-on-one with Mickie James. Oh, what a clothesline by Jax. Oh, and another one. You know, there's a reason why Nia Jax goes by the nickname the Irresistible Force, and it's because she is a force to be reckoned with, ladies and gentlemen. Suplex by James. We're not saying it's impossible to beat her, we're just saying that it takes a lot of guts, a lot of heart. Very few people can say that they have one-on-one victories against Nia Jax. One of those people is Asuka. Mickie James sending Nia Jax into the ropes, but Nia Jax with the reversal. DDT by Jax! There is a reason why Nia Jax seeks in the position she is right now as Raw Women's Champion, and it's because of her power and her athleticism. Nia Jax now on the prowl over Mickie James with a headbutt. And if you're Mickie James, this is the, oh man, this is the moment where you re-strategize. This is the moment where you see exactly where things are going wrong and try to fix them. Oh man, dropping down. That elbow. Oh, and there's a leg drop by Nia Jax. That could be enough. Shoulders down, but Mickey's on the ropes. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. Nia Jax on the prowl again. She's looking to hook her in here. But Mickie James with the reversal. Look at that. Neck breaker by the six-time women's champion. Like we said, oh no. Oh, and Nia Jax ducks out of the Mick kick. And things are suddenly bad for Mickie again. As Nia Jax takes all the air out of her. Jax now sending James into the corner. Here comes Jax. Once again up the second rope. Once again taking all the air out of Mickie James.
dropping down the elbow. And Nia Jax looking to put Mickie James away here. She hooks her in. Oh, what a slam by Nia! And Nia is not done with Mickie just yet. Here we go, look out! Samoan drop! Shoulders down, hooks the leg, isn't enough to put Mickie away here. Got her! Well, Nia Jax victorious tonight, perhaps sending a message. Oh, no, wait a minute! Alexa Bliss is in the ring! And Alexa Bliss with a sneak attack on Nia Jax. Nia never saw it coming. The former Raw Women's Champion with her signature moonsault knees to the plexus. And the former champion is on the prowl now. Hooking Nia in for the DDT. Message sent. Alexa wants that championship and she wants it as soon as possible. She has to wait 3 more weeks. In universe time, ladies and gentlemen. As Nia Jax defends her championship for the first time against Alexa Bliss. At Backlash. And up next, ladies and gentlemen, our main event, the Big Dog, the Architect, Roman Reigns, Seth Rollins, our main event, Raw, next. Baltimore, Maryland, as the Intercontinental Champion makes his way to the ring for our main event. Welcome back to Raw. This is Universe Mode on Twitch. And tonight we've seen all of the participants in the World Championship match at Backlash compete in separate matches. We saw Kevin Owens and Finn Balor. That one was won by Finn Balor via disqualification after Kevin Owens used a steel chair. And now we're seeing an old rivalry renewed when the Intercontinental Champion Seth Rollins goes one-on-one against Roman Reigns. You know, Seth Rollins has the possibility to make history becoming the first man since 2002 to hold both the Intercontinental and World Heavyweight Championship at the same time. That's, of course, if he wins the World Heavyweight Championship in 3 weeks Universe Time at Backlash. But this man has something to say about it. The Big Dog! Roman Reigns is here!
And it's for Brooklyn's home for you. Maybe 6 pounds. Roman Reigns!
The last time that Roman Reigns was World Heavyweight Champion, the title was taken from him by Seth Rollins at Money in the Bank 2016. We've come full circle now. And in 3 weeks Universe Time at Backlash, Roman Reigns and Seth Rollins join Kevin Owens and Finn Balor to compete for the World Heavyweight Championship in a fatal four-way matchup. One of these four men will be representing Monday Night Raw as our world champion for the foreseeable future. And Roman Reigns, the man that likes to call himself the guy here on Monday Night Raw, the man that says that this is his yard now, would love to walk out of Newark representing Monday Night Raw as his world champion
once more. There's the bell. Here we go. Roman Reigns, Seth Rollins, one on one. Like I mentioned during the entrances, the final time that we saw Roman Reigns as a world champion on Monday Night Raw was back in 2016 when Seth Rollins defeated him at Money in the Bank for the World Heavyweight Championship. That very same night, Dean Ambrose cashed in Money in the Bank and took the championship from Seth Rollins, leading to the eventual Shield Triple Threat at Battleground the following month. And now here we are on this post-WrestleMania world where Kurt Angle wants to know where Brock Lesnar is, and Brock Lesnar doesn't show up. Seth Rollins is the Intercontinental Champion, and we have four contenders to crown a new World Champion here on Monday Night Raw. Things are looking up here on Monday Night. Ooh, beautiful standing moonsault by the Intercontinental Champion. Pops to recover, hooks the leg here. Kick out by the Big Dog. Both of these men are very hungry for a world title run. Seth Rollins has proclaimed that he wants to make 2018 the year of Seth Rollins, and so far he's been succeeding. He's been putting off incredible performances on Monday Night Raw week in and week out, and he's the current Intercontinental Champion. In the meantime, Roman Reigns thinks that he should be Universal Champion, even though he failed to capture the championship from Brock Lesnar at WrestleMania. But of course, Brock Lesnar is not here to refute anything. We probably won't see Brock Lesnar up until the summer, which is why Raw needs a new world champion, and which is why we're doing this Fatal 4-Way matchup at Backlash in 3 weeks Universe time. Reversed by Reigns. Reigns now, carrying Rollins and sending him back down with canvas. That's the power of the Big Dog right there. And Roman Reigns now, carrying Seth Rollins up his shoulders, depositing him throat first into those ropes. Remember those ropes, they have a here's the cover, hooks the leg here, kick out by the Intercontinental Champion. Those ropes, they have metal wiring under the red tape. No picnic to fall on those ropes. So far so good for the Big Dog here tonight in the opening moments of this match. Suplexing Rollins back in the ring. If you take a look at the field of four contenders, four men who are perhaps long overdue an opportunity at the World Championship, four men, slim played by Rollins, four men who are long overdue an opportunity at becoming World Champion or a world title run. From any scenario to look at it, this could be a win-win situation for Monday Night Raw. Roman hits the Superman punch on Rollins. This could be the closing moment of this match. Spear by Roman Reigns. Spear by the Big Dog. Shoulders down. Hooks the leg. And a kick out at two by the Intercontinental Champion. These two are former WWE Tag Team Champions together. They know each other well enough to reverse each other's moves as Seth Rollins here pulls it gently. Waits for Roman to get back up. Barricade! Shoulders down! Hooks the leg on the Big Dog! Is it enough? And a kick out by Roman! And now Roman in a precarious position on the ropes. Rollins sends him to the outside of the ring. Roman Reigns could be in trouble here. Seth Rollins jockeying for position. Rollins takes to the ropes. Suicide dive by Rollins. A beautiful suicide dive into the barricade puts Roman on the defensive position of this match. As Seth Rollins now heads to the ring, heads to the top rope, follows that up with a beautiful frog splash from the top rope into the outside of the ring. These two know each other. Rollins knows what it takes to beat Roman Reigns, and he's pulling out all the stops here tonight on Raw. Standing kick to the back of the head by Rollins. Roman Reigns, very wise, rolls out of the ring. The referee trying to keep Rollins in the ring as Roman Reigns returns. Oh, what a kick by Rollins. And Rollins now with Roman Reigns in the right position. Standing moonsault on the big dog. Here comes Rollins. From the top rope all the way across the ring. Beautiful maneuver off the top rope. Hooks the leg on the big dog. Is it enough? Yes, it is. Rollins takes the victory. A huge victory for Seth Rollins as we prepare for the biggest main event in Monday Night Raw history. Fatal 4-Way. Finn Balor. Kevin Owens. Roman Reigns. Seth Rollins, one of these men, come 3 weeks Universe time, will be our new World Heavyweight Champion. Thank you so much for joining us. Stay tuned for SmackDown. Good night.